Now, therefore, the book of Daniel has been a battlefield between the conservative and liberal scholars. And I don't care to enter into that too much. A great deal has had to do with the dating of Daniel. Porphyry, a heretic in the 3rd century A.D., he declared that the book of Daniel was a forgery, written during the time of Antiochus, Epiphanes, and the Maccabees. That'd be around 170 B.C., almost 400 years after Daniel had lived. Now, the German critics seized upon this hypothesis, and along with Dr. Driver, they developed this type of criticism. Now, these critics, as well as present-day unbelievers, they assume the premise that the supernatural does not exist. Hence, there can be no foretelling, since foreknowledge is supernatural, and you couldn't prophesy. But the very interesting thing is that the Septuagint, the Greek version of the Old Testament, which was written prior to the time of Antiochus Epiphanes, it contains the book of Daniel. And that's the reason the liberal scholar hasn't done very much about the Dead Sea Scrolls. My, he came at it with a bang at the beginning, but if you've noticed, they don't talk much about them today. Why? Because they confirm the fact that at that time there was only one Isaiah. And those boys, they would like to have a duet of Isaiahs. Some of them want a trio of Isaiahs. But the interesting thing is, Dead Sea Scrolls are very much alive. They're live scrolls, and they rather refute the liberal critic. It's interesting how these things in time are always answered. And if you'll notice, the heretic and the critic and the one that's gone off in a cult always move in an area of the Bible where at the present we don't have full knowledge of it. And so if you're going to speculate, everybody can speculate, you see, and for that reason, you can speculate any way you want to, and they generally speculate the wrong way. But generally, it works out that we find out that the Word of God is accurate. Now, Josephus, Flavius Josephus, he records an incident during the time of Alexander the Great, which supports the early authorship. When Alexander's invasion reached the Near East, Jaddua, the high priest, went out to meet him, showed to him a copy of the book of Daniel, in which he was clearly mentioned. And Alexander was so impressed by this that instead of destroying Jerusalem, he entered the city peaceably and worshiped at the temple. Well, may I say to you that these things, you know, they contradict the critics, and yet there are some people go on blindly today. Now, it's not, therefore, in the purview of these brief notes that we're giving you now to enter into useless argument and fight again about that which has already been settled. I want to say that I accept the findings of conservative scholarship that the man Daniel was not a deceiver, and that his book was not a forgery. We feel that the statement of Pusey is apropos here. I'm quoting again. The rest which has been said is mostly mere insolent assumptions against Scripture, grounded on unbelief. And it was Sir Isaac Newton who declared, to reject Daniel is to reject the Christian religion. Now, our Lord Jesus, he called the Pharisees hypocrites, but he called Daniel the prophet. That's interesting. I, very frankly, I go along with the Lord Jesus. I call Daniel the prophet, and I call these critics hypocrites today. That's my idea, of course. Could be wrong. Now, will you notice? I don't think the Lord Jesus, though, reversed his arrangement. And the endorsement of the Lord Jesus Christ is valid and sufficient for every believer, whether he's examined the arguments of the critics or not. It satisfies the sincere saint without his having studied the answers of conservative scholarship. He can recognize that Daniel is spoken of in the New Testament as a prophet. Now, that leads me to say just a word about Daniel before we get into the book of Daniel. I think we know more of Daniel, the man, than we do of any other prophet. He gives us a personal account of his life from the time he was carried captive to Babylon, and that was in the third year of the reign of Jehoiakim, which was about 604 or 606 B.C., until the first year of King Cyrus, which was about 536 B.C., and Daniel's life and ministry bridge the entire 70 years captivity. At the beginning of the book, he's a boy in his teens. At the end, he's an old man of 80 and more years. Now, here is God's estimate of the man Daniel. O Daniel, a man greatly beloved. I wouldn't want to be a critic and call Daniel a forgery and someday have to face Daniel and find out in heaven he has a pretty good reputation. A man greatly beloved. I could only wish that the critic had that kind of a reputation in heaven and on earth.